Welcome back to Fit for Life. I'm really kind of excited about this show because I think I might be telling you a few things that you're not aware of. The name of the show is Don't Just Sit There, because you know what happens when we sit for long periods. Too much sitting is actually really bad for our health, especially as we get older. We should be taking breaks and things like that. Maybe you already know that, but when I watch PBS and I watch, you know, one of my favorite shows, and it's a series and I look forward to it every week, and I never miss it, I try to get up because sometimes they're an hour and a half. If I watch a Netflix movie, those could be 3 hours. I mean, there's no way that anyone should be sitting 3 hours. Again, especially us. It causes a decline in blood flow. Guess where? Right here, your legs. We can't afford that. We cannot afford that. Keep that in mind. Decline in your blood flow, your circulation, which again, we have to keep going. It contributes to hardening of the arteries, which is called atherosclerosis. And that's where the lining of the blood vessels get very stiff. And we develop plaque and all that great stuff. So I'm hoping you're gonna remember all these things, or at least know that it isn't good, right? Your brain is the least productive when you're sitting, because your body must move to deliver oxygen to the brain. That's food for the brain. Keep it in mind. The brain is the least productive when sitting. It must move and deliver oxygen and glucose. I forgot the glucose part. So those things are food for the brain, and it's really, really important. When we sit, the brain kind of downshifts. That's your ability to pay attention, and it also affects your short-term memory. We can't afford that either. So I'm hoping you folks will do your aerobics, just jump, walk, you know, just take your walks, your daily walks, if you can, run in place, march in place. Try to do it. Even when the weather's bad, you have to stay home, but it doesn't mean you can't do anything. You can also dance. You know, I put music on and it makes me feel like dancing. So we're going to do some aerobics today. But before we do, I'd like to do some nice warm-up exercises for our feet. But first, very first, our thoughts for the day. I found this to be interesting. I wasn't going to read it, but I said it might be of interest to you. Age puzzles me. I thought it was a quiet time. My 70s were interesting and fairly serene, but my 80s are passionate. I grow more intense as I age. And this is an author named Florida, Scott Maxwell. I read one of her books in a course I took on women and aging. Some of it was a little depressing, but we don't have to get depressed just because we're old. We can still keep busy and hopefully not curb our enthusiasm. Stay excited about life, learn new things. This is a good one. A reporter was interviewing the oldest woman supposedly in the world. I think she's lived to about 122. And he asked her a question. He said, "What do you expect the future to be like?" And she said, "Very short." Isn't that good? So she still had her mind and some humor. It says, "When we recall the past, we usually find it is the simple things, not the great occasions, that in retrospect give off the greatest glory of happiness." And that was Bob Hope. And didn't he have a great sense of humor? So I hope you have your water with you. Let's do a little foot exercise here. Let's flex those feet back and forth. I'm going to try to sit up straight, though. You're going to sit up straight if you keep your back away from the back of the chair, because it's so comfy, we just want to relax. So let's try to sit nice and straight, tightening your abdomen just by lifting your legs up, just by doing this. And this can be done anywhere. This is not a special exercise, but it's good for us. This is one of the morning exercises I do in bed. One foot down, you're going to circle that foot, make that ankle nice and flexible, get the blood circulating. So if you are sitting too long, this is another exercise you can do. You can do this under a table if you're out to dinner. Just make sure you don't kick the person across from you, right? So let's do the other. I like this one. feels good. Let's go the other way on this. All right. Now I'd like to bend the foot a little bit. And how do we do that? We just lift the heels up. Two, three. You can feel that in your calf muscle, can't you? Five. The joy of movement. Six. Keep going. Couple more. This is an easy one. All right. Now push your feet forward and just lift your toes up. One. Feel that in your calf muscle, your ankle, your foot. Easy stuff. But at least we're moving. Great. So let's shift from the feet to the hands. Let's do a little exercise with the hands here. So you're going to circle. Just circle those hands. Great for arthritis. And five, six, and seven, and eight. Circle the other way. And two. Easy, easy, easy peasy, as they say. Six, and seven, and eight. Each finger to the thumb. Good. And go back again. Let's do one more set. You notice my toe is going too, because I've got rhythm. Oh yeah, big time. Circle just the thumb. That's where a lot of arthritis collects, in that thumb joint, doesn't it? Oh yes, it does. Now we're gonna stretch the whole hand and the forearm. So you're gonna pull those fingers back. Your arm is out fairly straight, pulling back. Oh, I can really feel that today. Must be the ring. Pull it back. That's what it was. Let's do the other side. Stop. Like you're saying stop to someone. Pull that hand back. Good. All right. Now just let the hands drop down. Move your arms this way. One hand on top of the other and very gently push down. Easy stuff. But good for us. Just stretches all of this out, and we'll try the other side. Wonderful. Can actually feel that a little bit in my shoulder. All right. Now we're going to do some aerobics. Take a little water first. I'm going to do that too in a minute. I'm going to put some music on for us. And here we go. Get ready, get ready. So we are going to move. The opposite of sitting, right? Get that blood flowing a little bit. Burn a few calories. Easy. We're going to do some nice, simple steps. Good. If you don't want to use your arms, you don't have to, but mine just kind of do this naturally. Aren't you feeling better, more alive? Yeah? Back and forth. Good. Now we're going to kick out to the front. Kick. 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 Push one arm out. Your arms are in opposition, yes? Push. Push. Good. Just like you're walking. Now lift that knee up. Good. So we're strengthening the legs too. You are strengthening your heart and your lungs when you do cardio or aerobic exercise. It means using oxygen. Keep going. Now try this without the arms, just the legs. Good. Three, four, five, six, seven. Good. Let's do it again. I said no arms and it just happened naturally, so let's try another set. Good, good. Last one coming up, great. So forward and back, forward. We did side to side, now we're gonna go front to back, great. This is Santana, Maria is the name of it. Great. Are you out of breath? If you are, you should stop. But you're gonna feel something if you're not used to doing it, right? But you know your own body. You have limits. Sometimes we need to push, sometimes not. The other leg forward and back. Forward and back. Forward and back. What I'm doing with the stationary foot is My heel just kind of goes up and down naturally. You don't have to. You can do front, back if you want. Front, good. Front, back. Front, good. Front, good. Front, and we're going to stop here now. We're going to cross over. Good for balance, good for your heart, good for lungs, good for everything because you're moving, moving, moving. Remember, the music makes everything easier, doesn't it? It does for me. Cross, cross. It doesn't have to be a big cross. And if you can't cross, just move, you know, lift your leg up or just touch the floor. And just anything to keep with the rhythm of it. Good. Good. All right, now let's stop right here and just march in place. Whoa, this feels good. Yes. Marching in place. Good. Lift up a little higher this time. Good. And then you're going to kick again. Forward. Little break here. Out. Out. Now to get your heart rate up a little more, you want to use your arms too. So let's try that. We're going to stop here. All right, now watch. You're going to push up as you go down. Up, 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 up. Good. Love it, love it. Up again and here, here, here. Good. Up. Oh, that went too fast. I want to keep going. Did a great job. Let's turn that off. Grab some water again. Good. All righty. I'm going to have some water anyway. What I thought we might do today is, and yes, we probably do some of it in every class, because we're moving. And we have been moving. We've done our aerobic exercise, and it's a really good time to stretch. So we're going to do what I call full body stretching. And I'm just going to go, with whatever comes to my mind first. And starting with a sip of water. Your posture will be involved because a lot of stretching is involved in posture. So let's do the Y first, okay? And what I want you to do is really get those arms up there, very gently pull them back and pull them back. Now, I told you that we don't do what they call ballistic stretching, which is a bounce. This is the only one where I might give you a little movement because it might not be too comfortable the first time you do it, right? So this is called the Y, great for posture. It opens up the chest. You're stretching these muscles, your pectoral muscles right here. Good. Now we move down to the T exercise. This part's easy. It's kind of out from the shoulder and very gently push back. Your shoulder blades will come together. This will open up. It gets all congested when we sit like this. I don't know how anyone can breathe like this. And there are some people that can't help it. This is just the way their body has aged. So we don't want that to happen. So move it back. Oh, feels great. Now, do you remember the W? We've done this before. Elbows bent, just bring those elbows back and hold it. Look up at the ceiling this time, just a little bit. All right. Let's bring the hands together as if we're praying. Let's take a breath together just to relax all the way up. And when you exhale, go back, back, back. Make that exhalation longer than the inhale. Should be a little bit longer, right? Oh yeah. Wonderful. Again, let's do a nice upper body twist. How will we do that? You can sit all the way back on this one. You're going to take this arm. Grab the arm of the chair. I'm going to move over just a little bit. Grab the arm of the chair. Now, if you can do it, grab the back of the chair. But don't go with the turn. I want you to turn your head in the opposite direction, if you can. If you cannot do the back of the chair, hold on here. If not here, maybe the outside of the leg. But you want a good twist.
Yeah.
How does that feel? Sometimes you might hear a little clicking. Just be careful. All right, we'll come back slowly. This time we're going to do it with the yoga breath. So let's breathe up through the nose. And exhale and just bring that arm around. I have to move over just a little bit because I want to get to the back of the chair. Turn your head in the opposite direction. This is a full upper body stretch. This is a really good one. And I don't think we've done it in quite this way before. It's a really good one. And then we'll come back slowly, slowly. All right. I'd like you to just hold on to either side with one hand. Try to get close to that side where you're holding on. Let this arm drop. And let's do a little bend here. You're holding here. And see if you can touch the floor. I think most people can do that easily. Let's try it with the fist. We'll shorten the arm a little bit. So you're just gonna go down and see the difference. Takes a little more effort. Just be careful. You'll know if this isn't something you should be doing, right? So we're coming down, good. And we'll come back up. All right. You're gonna move over here, holding on. So you're close to where you're holding on. Just let the arm flop over, that's all. We'll do a little bend. You can touch. Most of us can touch. Yeah. Now make a fist and see if you can touch. So that's a good stretch too. I like that. And then we'll come back up. Now there are four basic stretches for the spine. We've already done some of them, but let's try it anyway. All right. Let's do spinal flexion. Oh boy, how do you do that? Just come forward. Keep your head up if you have to. All right. Drop those arms down. You should feel a stretch in your lower back, your mid back a little bit. If you don't or you're uncomfortable, just stop doing it. Don't want anything to happen, right? This is spinal flexion. Good, and we'll slowly come back up. How does that feel? Now we're gonna do spinal extension. So you're kind of flattening out that cervical curve in your upper back. And how do we do that? Just by pulling the arms up and very gently pulling them back and holding it. So we did flexion. This is called spinal extension. Now we've already done a spinal twist or what they call a rotation, right? So we'll just hold on to the arm. We'll just go through it a little bit. Spinal rotation, twisting. The other side. And again, you need to be holding these at least 10 seconds. You can also do these with the yoga breath. Now there's one other movement that the spine can do, and it's bending. Spine can bend. So we did what? Flexion. We did extension. We did rotation. And now we're going to bend. So we can sit back on this one. I'd like to try this. Take this hand, cross over, and with the opposite, reaching up, just copy what I'm doing. Let's do this with the yoga breath. You're breathing up through the nose. And, oh yes, exhaling as you bend. Not this. I want a good reach. Reaching. You're going to feel it all the way down. So it's wonderful to stretch most of the upper body. I'll tell you that right now. Yeah. And then the other side, switch. Reach up with the breath. And exhale, but make sure you're reaching with the bend. You're not rounding. Reaching up and bending. Okay, keep that in mind. And how does that feel? I hope it feels good. All right, now we're going to do something that is going to stretch your hip out a little bit. Let's try this. You may not have done this one before. You're going to just lift that leg up if you can. If you cannot bring your leg up like this, you can cross down here at the ankle. Yeah, that's good. So let's bring it up. I'm going to hold on both hands right here. Look what happened to my posture, right? So I'm going to use this to pull against, to sit where I should be. Ears over shoulder, shoulder over hips. If we were standing, it should be hips over knees and knees over ankle, but we're not doing that right now. Holding on and pull yourself up nice and tall. Now, doesn't that feel good? You look younger, you can breathe better. It's important, especially with aging, isn't it? Can you bring the leg in a little bit closer? I hope you can. Nice and tall. We're gonna hold it for at least another 10 seconds, okay? Great. You can flex your foot back and forth if you want. You can circle a little bit, but try to maintain that nice flat back. And you can kind of pretend you're just sitting like this sometimes and get a stretch in when there's other people around. Let's try the other side now. Lift that leg up. Right away, the posture goes. What can I say? Pull yourself up nice and tall. Sit up straight. Right inside the knee here. Push that down. We didn't do it on the other side, but you will next time, right? Push down. Try this with me. Take this hand, and there's an opening here underneath, and then hold on to the leg. So this is good for the hip. One side is going to be a little stiffer than the other, I'll tell you that right now. But this is the one that's a little tougher for me. So we're also not stretching just the hip, but you're improving, you're opening up your chest, and you're improving your posture. Really, really important. All right, good. Okay. Now we're going to do another little stretch for the side, but it's also going to be a toner and tightener for your abdomen, okay? So you're going to put your fingertips at your neck, unless you want to clasp your hands and put them back there. Just do that. And you're going to lift one leg up and bring the opposite elbow over and then put it down. Doesn't have to touch. If it can touch, that's fine. But you have to work at that a little bit. So you're crossing over and over and over. Good. Let's do just 8 of these, and 5 and 6. So you're stretching and strengthening both. Good. That's enough. Let's relax. Grab some water again. You've had a pretty good workout today, so now we're just going to do a little simple meditation. Let's call it a relaxation meditation. All right. So we can be comfortable now. We don't have to sit up straight. You can't be straight every minute of every day. So we'll just kind of sit back. If you want to be more comfortable, you can just slide forward a little in the chair, if that's possible. Both legs out, or one, whichever is more comfortable for you. Good. All right, let's just drop the head down now. Keep your eyes closed on this one. And you can just listen to my voice and just lift your head up, keep your eyes closed, and just make believe you're looking up at the stars. Do we have a good imagination? Sometimes. All right. And now keep the head straight. You can close your eyes or open, either one is fine. Let's just turn that head slowly to one side. And then to the other side. All right. Now we're going to work. You're going to open your eyes. We're going to work with the yoga breath. So let's do that together to start. You're going to breathe up through your nose. Hold it. And exhale through your mouth. And when you get to a point where you think you don't have any more air, push it a little bit. See if you can get a little bit more air out, more on the exhalation. The exhalation should be longer, as I've said many times. Good, and then we'll bring the head up. Good. Now just for maybe, oh, I don't know, let's try for a minute. We'll start with the breath, not yet. But after we take that breath, I'd like you to try to clear your mind. And we can do that by trying to think about nothing, which is almost impossible because the mind is wily. It wants to be moving all the time, so it can drive you crazy. So what you want to do is take the yoga breath with me right now, all the way up through your nose. And when you exhale, your mind will be easier to clear. Why don't you just think about something that is relaxing, a bucolic scene, or an English garden, or you're sitting in a field, something that relaxes you, maybe the sun on your back, with your chin dropped down a little bit. Good. Move your head from side to side. Just put a picture of something in your mind that is relaxing to you, maybe a brook, maybe the ocean, or a lake, or a fireplace. It's a little warm for that now, but keep your mind on that to the exclusion of anything else that wants to come in there. And when the thought does come in, acknowledge it and just let it drift away. And the way to do that is to take another yoga breath. So let's do it all together. Up through the nose. Hold. And breathe out through the mouth. Keep breathing out, out, out. Wonderful. Are you going to stay here in this relaxed state? Oh, I'm going to say for about a minute. Keep your mind on that beautiful scene. Keep it locked in. When the thoughts come in, oh, I've got to do this, I've got to do that, take another breath. And I promise you, if you do this enough, it does work. So for the next minute, I'm not going to say anything, which is pretty unusual. And here we go. Open your eyes when you're ready, and I'm going to say namaste, peace, and see you next time, and thanks for working out with me. You won't be sorry. Bye-bye.